Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So the challenge 35 Total Madness is coming out April 1st. They came out with a trailer a couple weeks ago, but yesterday they just came out with the super trailer. So I wanted to go through it with you guys, tell you some things I saw in it, and go through the whole cast and spill some tea on everything that I know and see what you guys think. And let's do this.
Savage game moving forward.
This is my shot. I'm gonna take it. Everything is insane.
You know why I win with? Because I'm mentally in the game.
My entire challenge career, I've been waiting for the stars to align for you guys to face off. And now it is here.
What do you think it's gonna be, guys?
We're living in a bunker with no windows and no doors.
I'm going crazy on day one.
Don't feel I'm fighting for all my friends to make it look like I'm a bad guy.
That's not your friend, Sergeant!
I'm gonna lose my mind in here. Don't touch me. You're the person I wanna be with, absolutely.
I don't believe it.
Listen!
I don't believe it because everything you've ever told me has been a lie.
Do you wanna quit, Jenna?
If you're not good here, you won't be good out there.
Why are you guys
oh my god. You're a boy. And I ruined a relationship for somebody who doesn't give a about me.
It's just so hard to tell you he's being genuine.
I want him to just leave me alone.
I'm not scared of competition. This is crazy. I didn't expect it to be this hard.
This long, I've been through so much, it's gotta be worth something.
Just because people hate him, he wants people to hate me.
Your brain, your body, everything will be tested.
Everyone's losing their mind.
You're the foulest one here. You have no respect for yourself.
This place is meant to like break you.
Someone's getting evacuated.
Hey, best girl. I don't trust anybody. You shouldn't. There's $1 million on the line.
All right. What do you guys think? So, it comes out April 1st. And I love how TJ starts it off saying that he ain't having no more people floating by. He ain't doing that skating by shit. He's having everyone win in an elimination to get to the finals. So you have to go in an elimination and you have to win or you ain't going to the end. And I love that because in previous seasons, people just skate right by, chill the whole time and make it right to the finals. Usually the veterans will stick together and send the rookies home. They won't go in the elimination at all. So I love that aspect of it. The elimination ground is called the Purgatory, if you saw. They saw the overview of the whole ring, so that's where all the eliminations are going to be, and it looks like there's going to be a bunch of crazy eliminations, and they're fighting for $1 million this time. It's going to be in the Czech Republic, in Prague. You bitches can't even spell Prague.
Then go to Prague. Now you bitches can't even spell Prague. But...
But they're going to be living in an underground bunker, like a bomb type shelter, so I wonder how that's going to be. I heard it's going to be really tough on them, and that person that was getting evacuated, I heard it's like a really good player that's been in the game. They're really strong, and a lot of people were breaking down. So I wonder how the elements are going to be down there, because it didn't look that bad from the trailer, but I heard it was really bad for them. So see how that plays out. They're all going to be fighting for that $1 million, and you have to win an elimination to go in, so they better bring the game faces. And let's get to the cast that I have. We have a couple new faces and a bunch of other people. I think there's like 27 people, so we got a lot of people. But for the new people, from Big Brother, we have Swaggy C. And he's going on with his girlfriend, Bailey. They were both on Big Brother together. I actually really liked Bailey. And they're a couple. They're engaged. So I wonder how that's going to work in the house. If people are going to, like, see them as a threat. Especially because they're rookies. They usually throw in their rookies first. So them being a couple might not be good together. But I am rooting for Bailey. I like her. And I hope her and Swaggy can do good together. And they have Fessy also from their Big Brother season going in with them. And they were in an alliance in the Big Brother house. So I think they're going to stick together in the challenge house also. And another person from the Big Brother season is Casey. And she was the winner of their season, which was Big Brother 20. So all four of them will be on together. But Casey wasn't in an alliance with them in the Big Brother house. And in a clip in the trailer, you see Bailey screaming at Kaylee. So I wonder if they're going to be beefing the whole time or if they're going to stick together, because I think it might be smart for them to stick together because they're already going to be known as a target. They're going to be known as the Big Brother people, and people are going to put them in the same alliance anyways. But maybe you never know. They could split up. If she's beefing with Casey, maybe Casey got an ins with somewhere else, or Bailey got an ins with somewhere else, and they end up going their separate ways. But I'm curious to see how that plays out, because it's going from the Big Brother house, which I love that show too, to the Challenge house. So I'm curious to see that, and I'm glad to see some people from Big Brother on there. So let's see what happens with that. We also have Asaf. He was on Are You the One season 4, and he was on Are You the One Second Chances. He was also on So You Think You Can Dance season 12. He's done a bunch of shows. He actually just won the Big Brother VIP season in Israel, so he's going in there. He got all this rap under him. I wonder how that's going to be. I don't really know a lot about him, but he has a lot of shows under his belt, so hopefully he can come in and shake up the challenge game and see what he can do on there. And another person we have is Jennifer Lee. She was just on The Amazing Race 29, but she was eliminated first, so I don't really know a lot about her. I'm curious to see what she brings. I wonder if she's going to be an early out. Maybe she can be a wild card, a dark horse. I don't know much about her, but I'm curious to see. So hopefully she brings something good to the table. The last rookie that we have is Jay. He was on Survivor. He was on Gen X versus Millennials. And he made it 36 days, but he played an idol wrong and he got voted out. But he made it really far. He almost made it to the end. So I wonder how he's going to be in the house, because So the lights just went out of my house. I heard a big bang in the backyard and everything went pitch black. I thought it was my computer for a second, but everything in my whole room went out. So I'm wondering what's going on. But I'll keep you guys posted once everything gets back on, once the lights turn back on. It was crazy. I hope I got that on video. I'm going to try to edit it right now and see what's going on. But I'll be back. I'm back, guys. I figured out it was a transformer at the top of my street that blew out, so they finally fixed it. It's been like an hour and a half, and I'm back. So back to what I was saying. That was crazy. If you actually rewind it, you can hear like the big bang. It was nuts. But everything's fixed now, and we're back on track. So as I was saying, I think it's going to be interesting with Jay in the house, because when he was on X on the Beach, he was dating Morgan Willett. And now she's dating Johnny, which brings us to our first veteran, Johnny Bananas, obviously. And this is going to be his 20th season. And I wonder how that's going to play out with Jay. I wonder if they're going to have a beef in the house. I wonder if Johnny's going to try to come for him or if he's going to try to come for Johnny. But it's going to be good to see. I think Johnny might try to get in with the Big Brother players, I'm thinking. So I think he might click up with them four if they're together and try to do something with them. And the next veteran we have is Wes, and he's back for his 13th season. And him and Johnny have their battle going on like always, so I wonder if that's going to continue, or maybe they're going to switch it up and come together. You never know. But the last we saw Wes, he was on War of the Worlds 2, and he lost to Bear in the Firing Squad elimination. So I'm wondering how that's going to play out with him and Bananas. So I'm wondering how their rivalry is going to play out. We always know it's something every season, so it's, I'm wondering if that's the elimination CJ was talking about in the trailer when he said that he's been waiting for this forever, for these two people to go together. I feel like it might be them, because everybody's been waiting for them to go to, against each other, so that would be so awesome. And then we have CT next. He's back for his 17th season, and he's coming off a win from last season. He's awesome. He's back with the dad bod. I love CT. He usually just lets Bananas and Wes and all them kill each other, and he chills back and does his thing. He feasted last season and he won, so I'm glad to see him back. So hopefully he can win again. I wouldn't mind that. I love CT. And then we have Kyle Christie, Crazy Kyle. We know he's back. He's back for his 5th season. And the last we saw him, he lost to Theo in the Running Riot elimination. That was a crazy elimination. So he's back again. But I wonder how his storyline's going to play out, because there's no Kara and there's no Paulie. And they usually tie into his storyline. So I'm wondering how it's going to play out for him. It might be good for him. We'll see. He can maybe fly under the radar and just lay back. But I'm curious to see where his story is going to go this season. And also repping the UK with Kyle, we have Bear. Stephen Bear, he's back again for his 5th season. And the last time we saw him, he lost against Joss in the hall brawl. But he's back, and he's definitely stirring up some tea. I got some tea for you on him in a minute when I bring up another cast member. But we'll see what he brings besides that. But he always brings the antics. He always has something crazy to bring. Which brings us to Kaylee. She's back for her 5th season. And I don't know if you guys saw in the trailer, but she's making out with Bear. And she's talking about ruining her relationship. She was with this guy, Mikey, for years. And she's on the show making out with Bear. So I wonder how all that tea is going to play out. I'm going to be sitting here sipping, watching, seeing all the craziness. But she's not even dating Mikey or Bear. She's actually dating this guy, Sam Bird. And they're in a relationship now after the show. So she cheated on her boyfriend, Mikey, on the show. And now she's dating Sam Bird. So I wonder how it all played out. But we'll see. And the last time we saw Kaylee, she got DQ'd on Final Reckoning for getting in an altercation with Melissa. They got in a fight and they both got eliminated. So Melissa's also back, and she's back for her 3rd season. And I actually have some tea on her too. She was actually pregnant on the show, but she didn't know. She didn't have any symptoms. But after the show, she came out and she said she was pregnant, and the timeline added up to her being pregnant on the show. So I wonder how that's going to play out too. And I wonder if her and Kayla's beef is going to continue, if they're going to squash it and move on. We will see. And then we also see Maddie, and she's back for her 2nd season. She's been on Floribama Shore, if you watch that. And she looks like she's a beast, so I think she's going to do good in a lot of challenges. So let's see what she has to bring. It's going to be her 2nd season. And the next person is Big T, which I'm really excited to see, because she got eliminated in the 1st episode last season, but I really liked her and she was a fan favorite, so I hope she comes back and I hope she does better than she did last time, and hopefully she'll make it far, because I think she has a lot to bring. And we have Nani. She's back for her 9th season. She made it all the way to the finals last season, and then she got eliminated right before the final challenge. So, will she make it far this time again? Can she get to the final or win? Let's see. I saw her fighting with someone in the trailer. It looked like she was yelling at someone, so I wonder who that is, but we'll see how far she makes it this time. And we have last season's winner, Dee. She's back again, but in the trailer, we see her getting into it with Rogan, which I'll get to next, but it looks like he's getting into an argument with her, and I hope she doesn't let him get in her head again, even though she still won last time. So I hope she doesn't let him get to her that bad. And I'm wondering how Rogan's going to do. He's back again, and this is going to be his 3rd season. And I wonder how he's going to do without Joss. And we're actually going to get to see him in an elimination, because even though he won last season also, we didn't get to see him in an elimination. So I'm curious to see if he gets that win to go to the finals and how he'll do in an elimination. And we're going to get to see how him and Dee play out, because obviously it's a continuing story. So we're going to get to see more of them and more of their drama. So let's see what they have to bring, and let's see if they both can make it to the final again, or if they're going to take each other out. And our next cast member we have is Jennifer West. She's back for her second season. She was on last season and she lost to Tori in the hall brawl. So I'm wondering what she's going to bring, because we only got to see one season of her. So she did look kind of beastly, like she could beast through the challenges. So I'm wondering how far she'll make it this time. And next we have Ashley Mitchell. She's back for her seventh season. Ashley Millionaire Mitchell, we all know she's infamous for taking the money from Hunter in Final Reckoning. She took the million all for herself, and she was on last season. She made it all the way to the final and got eliminated in the Purge Challenge. So will she break the curse this season and make it to the final this time? She made it close last time, so... Next cast member we have is Anissa. She's back for her 13th season, and she's the longest running OG out of all the females in the house. The last time we saw her, she lost the redemption game in Dirty 30. So I hope she comes back and kicks some ass, because I always love me some Anissa. So hopefully she comes back and does good this season. And we have Tori Deal. She's back for her fourth season. She made it all the way to the final Purge last season also, but she got eliminated right before the boat, right before everyone got on and won, which her boyfriend, actually fiance, was on. He made it and he won last season. So Jordan's back again. This is going to be his sixth season. He won last season, and he won three times altogether. So can he do a fourth one? Will he win back-to-back? Can him and Tori win together this time? We're all going to see it play out. We also have Josh Martinez back for his third season. He was on last season, but he lost to Jordan in the end of the rope elimination, which was an intense one. They were both there for so long sweating. But Jordan uses smarts and outsmarted him and pulled him off. So I'm curious to see if he can come back and win an elimination. He might cry a little bit, but he's tough too, so we'll have to see what he brings. And we have two players of the Young Buck Alliance this season. The first one's Nelson. He's back for his sixth season. And the last time we saw him and Chain lost to Bananas and Tony in the redemption game on Final Reckoning. And we also saw him on Dr. Phil with Angela. I don't know if you guys saw that, but him and Angela were on Dr. Phil. They've been dating and having all this drama. So we'll see how he does in the Challenge House. He's going to have his main alliance member, Corey Wharton. I'm sure they're going to work together. He's back for his seventh season. And the last time we saw him, he was getting DQ'd for slamming Tony on the ground in Final Reckoning. And we also see him on Teen Mom every Tuesdays. He's on Teen Mom OG with Cheyenne and Ryder. And he also has his other BM on there, Taylor. So now we're going to have him on Tuesdays on Teen Mom OG. And then we're going to have him in the Challenge House this season. So if you watch Teen Mom OG and the Challenge, you're going to get a double dose of Corey. So we'll see what they both have to bring. Hunter's at home with his baby right now. He just had a newborn. So congratulations to him. So they have two out of three members of the Young Buck Alliance. But I heard some tea that allegedly Fessy has been hanging out with the Young Buck Alliance. He's been hanging out with Corey and Nelson. So I wonder if he's going to link up with them this season, and if they're going to team up as a trio, and if they can do some damage. We're going to have to see. I'm excited. And lastly, we have Jenna. She's back for her eighth season. But we see in the trailer, she's having a lot of drama with Zach. She's arguing with him over Skype. But they did recently just get engaged. So I know they're engaged today. So I don't know what was going on the show. I don't know if they're still beefing at home. But they are engaged. And I wonder how that's going to play out on the show. We see CJ asking if she wants to quit. So I hope she doesn't quit. But if she does end up staying, I'm curious to see how her relationship with Nani and with Kayla's going to work out, because I know she's best friends with both of them. And I know Kayla has her drama going on with Bear, and Jenna has her drama going on with Zach. So it just seems like a big, messy situation. And I'm so excited to see how it's all going to pan out with everybody. I wonder what twists we have ahead. And I'm just excited for the season to start. So April 1st, everybody tune in. I have some other tea and some spoilers, so I might make an extra video about that, because I don't want to give any spoilers away. I try not to get any spoilers myself, but I end up seeing things when I'm getting tea from places and people hit me up and tell me tea, so I try not to spoil it for myself, but I try to get as much information. I know some elimination tea and all that. If you want me to make another video, let me know. But thank you guys so much for watching this one, and tune in April 1st to see the first episode. And I'm gonna maybe do a recall every week on each episode and a recap and go over it with you guys and see what you guys think. And in the comments down below, let me know who your guys' favorites are this season. Who do you want to win? Who do you hate the most? Who do you want to go home first? Let me know what you guys are looking forward to seeing. And if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button down below. And if you hit the bell icon, you'll be subscribed to more of my videos and you'll get to keep up with me every week if you want to do reviews with me. And until next time, when you can sip some tea with your girl Nikki Lee, I'll be here. Thanks, guys. Love you all.